steps game that kids can actually play and move their characters on the game and have lots of fun. We've also built in a roll the dice for you to help you build this game so that kids have lots of fun. Join me, let's have amazing time creating this game together. Canva and then access presentation, like a blank presentation to create your game. And this game we're creating is going to be like a safari one. So we're going to name the game Safari Steps Game. And we're going to then go ahead and look for the background for our game. You can go on your elements and search for jungle or safari so that you get a nice background. You can also create your own background. It's really up to you. I liked this one. That's a green jungle landscape. This is really nice and I enjoyed this one. Then once you click once on it and you add it on your canvas, you're gonna right click and set the image as your background. So that's your first step. Then you're gonna press text or T for your text to give your game a name. The font that I really enjoyed is the Rundeck Texture, and you select that. And then you give the game a name. So we've already named it Safari Jungle. And give it like a yellowish kind of a color to that lightish yellow, that sort of a color. And you can press R for rectangle just to put in a nice border behind the name of the game and just make it pop. And align that, and with your background, I would love for us to make that a little bit greener than the brown, maybe something like that. And then you can just make it a little bit transparent to pick out the background of the trees behind it so that it looks, you know, nice. Then you can group the two. You select the name as well as your safari border, and then just have them as one. Then your next step is to start building the game. You're gonna press R for your rectangle, and you're gonna be creating these squares, and you want 20 of these for us to be creating the game. So we just size them nicely, and we start off with a, just as a start, we start off with this shape that's going to start off the creation of our game. And since it's safari, we're gonna go nice green, and we're gonna have these nice textures of green, and we're gonna add a border with all of our shapes. So I'm going to add a border line and not make it that ugly black. I'll just look for another green, to maybe even darker green, just to make it nice and pop. And I'll press another rectangle. Then I will size it nicely on my game, on the border, so that it is the same size. You can always zoom in to make sure that your sizing is perfect. And since we're going to have a bonus and we're going to have a question, we are going to have different colors. So for our colors, we're going to go red, green, and yellow, just the basics. So let's go with the first one, which would be red. Then we put a border around it. Let's just check this border size. It was a 4, so we keep it consistent with the green that we created, and we make the border stroke 4. We align it nicely like that. Then we duplicate the shape, and then we scroll, we zoom in, and we bring it a bit down. Maybe that green or this light green, right? That looks quite nice if we use gradient. And then the third one is the yellow one. got all of our squares. Now we're going to look for the pot of gold. So we want to add that on there. This is our winner at the end of the game. So now we will start naming the square boxes that we've added. We are going to start over here. We're going to double click on the shape and we're going to type the words on there, because you can do that with Canva. And we want to use your Genti Sense. I like the Genti Sense. That's just nice and easy to read. And then you start adding instructions on all your boxes. AI has been very helpful with these for me. He helped me create the boxes that I can name for each and every square. So I'll just go copy there and then paste it on each square so that it fits. So I'm gonna reduce this to something like 25. Then it makes it fit each square quite nicely if you've made it 25 and it is Genti Sense. So you are going to have all of these squares have like a question or something the kid can do, that kids can do, and then they can play along as we progress on the game. So we're gonna make all of them like 25, so that each and every time they land on the square, they can play. Now that you've labeled each and every square box on here, you don't need to have them being clickable. So you can group them and then lock them so that they don't disturb the kids when they're playing. And then you lock your game like that. Next, you're going to look for the characters or the players of your game. So you can go to your elements and you can search for a little tiger and a little elephant. You can look for nice little players that you could have the kids choose to use to play with, and then they can be your characters. Now that we have our players, we want to make sure that we have instructions for how the game is played as well as roll the dice. So we're gonna press R for rectangle in order for us to have a place where we can add the rules of the game. And then I can start typing the game rules. I got ChatGPT to help me with the game rules. And the last thing would be the roll the dice. So with the roll the dice, and since the game is, we want the kids to be able to move the games, we're going to add an instruction of how to roll the dice. And once we do that, we're done with our game. So I'm going to add a shape. Canva has this gorgeous shape that you could use. So you're going to go to your elements and then you search for the different shapes that Canva has. The clouds that are here are really beautiful. The stars are also just as gorgeous. With your clouds, you can pick any of these that you could add your instructions on. I like this particular one. That's cloud 2. And I'm gonna make it nice and colorful and add it on here so that it is our roll the dice instruction to the players so they know what to do. So I'm gonna make it a nice gradient, colorful red color, and have a light border around it so that it is catchy and stunning. And then I add an instruction of how they can go find the game. It is very easy if you just type it out and they know what to do. We're giving them an instruction of rolling the dice. You need to open a new tab. So maybe we can make that capital letter. Open a new tab. Type roll a dice on Google or visit random.org/dice in order for you to get a dice. So I'm going to just go to my elements and search for a die so that they are aware that this is the instruction of how to go about rolling a dice on the game. If you're searching for a dice so that you can add it to your instructions of roll the dice, you're gonna search for dice and then look for the animated dice that Canva has and add that on there. It is free. So you just click on it once, and then as a square, add it on top of the roll the dice for that nice effect so they can see that this is the instruction for roll the dice. But how do the players play now? They have to have a roll the dice, or they can Google, like the instruction says, roll the dice. So when the game starts, they're gonna pick a player. And since you're going to make this game editable for the kids to play, and mine is also going to be editable, they're going to choose, I'm lion, I'm tiger, or I'm giraffe. And they can pick a player. And whoever starts to play, maybe giraffe is number one, they're going to go to roll the dice, because the instruction says, help your animal reach the treasure, which is this treasure. So in order to do that, they need to move across the pages. So they're going to need to start rolling the dice. They're going to go to the Google and they're going to click roll. And they get six. So tiger has six. So tiger moves. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. The instruction on six say, snap your hands like a crocodile. So then the kids go... and they snap their hands like a crocodile. I don't know if a crocodile snaps hands like that. Then he's number six. Then the next player is lion. Then the next player is lion. Lion, it's your turn. Roll the dice. Then lion goes to roll the dice. And lion is four. Then they go back to the game. So you're going to have two tabs. One where the game is at and the other one where you're rolling the dice. So lion is four. 1, 2, 3, 4. Lion gets a name, an animal with stripes. Lion says, oh, a zebra, yay! And then it's the giraffe's turn, and then giraffe rolls the dice and it goes up until the first one gets to find the treasure and that person wins. If you enjoy games like this, go watch this fruit and veg video that we've created just for you. We will see you on our next video.